What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today I'm going to show you how to render an interior view using Vray 3.4 for Sketchup. In this video, I will walk you through my design process, materials, and lighting setup. Make sure to stick around until the end because I will show you how to get this model for free. With that said, let's get started. First, let's sketch out the scene that I have in mind. I'm planning to do a daytime rendering of a dining room with the focal point being the table and the chairs in the foreground, while the background will have a bookcase and a framed picture or painting. The main light source will be coming from the windows on the right side, but I will also add some light fixtures so the ceiling won't look too empty. Finally, I'll finish it out with some decorations on the bookcase and the table. For the style, I'm thinking a mix of minimal and industrial. And for the materials, I'll use a combination of wood, concrete, and metal. With that in mind, I can now go to the Sketchup 3D warehouse and pick out my objects. And here's what I have so far. The only thing that's missing is the table. I'm trying to find something simple but elegant, and since I couldn't find anything I really like in the warehouse, I just decided to model one from scratch using some inspirations I found online. Now that I have all of my objects ready, I can assemble them and set up my view. But before I do that, let's change their materials to what we want and get them ready for render. For the table, I'm going to use a wood material for the top and a concrete material for the base. For the concrete material, I couldn't find any one material I like, so I decided to use the new blend material in Vray 3.4 to combine two materials that I found from flyingarchitecture.com and textures.com. And I did the same for the top of the table. If you want to know more about the Vray blend material, then check out my last tutorial. Now for the other objects I found on 3D Warehouse, some of these require more adjustment than others. Like for the plants, lights, chairs, and bookshelf, I replaced their existing materials with built-in Vray materials or textures I found online. Other objects like the Iron Man figure needs a little tweak, like adding the reflection to the material. And some are just good to go, like these books and this wood mannequin. For this picture, I'm going to do something different. I got this object for the frame but not the art, because I'm actually going to use one of my favorite photos that I took, the Brooklyn Bridge, and put it in place of the art. Now I'm going to add a layer of glass material on the outside. You can't see any difference here, but it will add more details in the rendering later. Since the table and chairs are the focal point, let's set them up first. Now I'm going to draw a footprint of the dining room, which is roughly 20 feet wide and 30 feet deep in this case. You can see that I left a lot of space here because that is where the camera is going to be. Now that we got the shell of the room, let's draw the windows. Since the windows won't be in the frame, I don't need to model them in detail. I just need to put two holes in the wall. In this case, there are 3x5 windows that are 2 feet off the ground. Now that the room is done, let's put in the rest of the furniture and decorations. Notice how there are empty spaces on the left and right side of the view. I'm going to crop that by setting my output aspect ratio closer to a square than a typical rectangle. Now I can show my save frame with this button here. That looks better. Now for the lighting. For the sunlight, I adjusted using the shadow settings so that it comes through the window like so. This will add more contrast to our composition and give it more depth to the rendering. As you can see, the sunlight alone is not enough. I can increase the multiplier to 2, but this will only make the sunlight more intense, and that's not what I want. I want to light up the scene overall, so I can use two rectangle lights. One is going to be inside of the room with the intensity of 50, and the other is outside with the intensity of 100. I also added another mesh light at the back of the room, but this will have a low intensity because I just needed to make the reflection of the light fixture in the glass a little more visible. Now that the scene is ready, I can set my output size here and the quality here, then hit that render button. While that's rendering, I'm going to show you where you can get this model for free. I've uploaded this model on gumroad.com. You can follow this link here to download it. It's a giveaway, so just enter 0 in this box and get it for free, but any donation is appreciated. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and the free model. Thank you so much for helping me reach 1000 subs. I have a full-time job outside of this, so it's a lot of work to keep making videos, but your positive feedback and support really motivate me to keep going. Thanks again, guys. That's all for today. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.